Welcome to this speed build video in The Sims 4. My name is Irene and today I am building my modern underground beach house. I really wanted to build something modern today because only 8 days left and the realm of magic back will be here. I'm so excited for that. But of course, with a magical pack, there will be a lot of fantasy builds coming. And I'm thinking about incorporating modern with fantasy too, but I'm not sure yet. But yeah, there will be a lot of fantasy builds coming. So that's why I really wanted to make something modern today. And I'm building this in Sulani because with the new pack, there will be 1.5 worlds. There will be 1 new world, Glimmerbrook, and there will be also a new magical world, but only with 1 lot to build on. But yeah, actually there will be 2 new worlds in that way. So I think I'm going to build a lot in the new worlds. So I really wanted to build in Sulani because I think Sulani is so, so pretty. And I wanted to do an underground house because I never did an underground house on my channel before. So I thought it was fun. But as you could see in the cinematic intro, there's a lot of stuff going on above ground in this build as well. Just to explain it a little bit, the whole house, really the house with the bedrooms and the bathrooms and the living room and the kitchen, everything will be underground and will be a lot of space, a modern interior, yeah, with really some modern edges and a very big pool and yeah, just a gorgeous interior. But yeah, it's in Sulani, and in Sulani you have like the tropical worlds with amazing views, with a whole ocean surrounding this lot. And I wanted to use the environment surrounding this lot a lot in this build. I'm saying lot a lot. So I wanted to do something on the exterior as well, above ground. So I decided to make a very modern structure above ground. That's really a place where you can lounge and just see the amazing views in this world. There will be a very modern bar. It's actually an indoor bar, but it has huge windows with, as I'm saying, amazing views. There will be an area to barbecue, an area with some sofas and some chairs. There will be some lounge chairs. There's actually a bathtub somewhere as well. And yeah, actually I located this build, or I placed this build this time a little bit different than I normally do, because normally I'm determining the way where the front of the build is with the lights, where the light's coming from, because I think it's the best that you have the lights when you're building during the day at the front of your build, because you can see what you're doing in your build and I can see it. No, I think that's the best way to go. But in this build, I actually went with the direction with the most gorgeous views. So that's why I flipped it around, because actually normally the front of the build is at the other side of the lot. So yeah, that's why I've placed it like this. But I actually ran in some troubles during building this, and it has to do with the gap that I'm creating right now. This is not an ocean lot. It is a lot in Sulani, but not an ocean lot. And that means that I could use terrain tools on this lot. And when I'm building in Sulani and when I'm building on a lot that isn't an ocean lot and I can use the terrain tools, I just want to use them. I use terrain tools a lot in my builds. I think, yeah, it's a fun tool. We did not have the terrain tools at the beginning when The Sims 4 just came out, or actually a couple of years, I think. So I'm so happy that we have the terrain tools now, so when I'm able to use them, I want to use them. So the same for this build. And I already had the plan in mind to create like a slope with a gap later on where you could see the underground house, and in that way I thought it was cool to connect the two spaces together. So yeah, I raised the build up, the structure. I'm already sighing, can you hear? Yeah, it took me so much time to figure this out. But I raised the build on your left up. Nah, yeah, not on your left. The above ground build, I lowered it. I raised it up. And then I raised the ground up. And then I created a slope. And then I put a hole in the ground where, yeah, just on the lowest part of this lot. And yeah, then I thought it was nice to put the entrance of the underground house in the structure that is above ground. Not just a hole in the ground with the stairs, but I thought it looked better to put it in the above ground structure. But yeah, of course, that structure is placed higher than the gap on your right. So I just placed the basement underneath it. And then I wanted to attach the two underground parts together. And yeah, of course, they were on a different height. So I wasn't able to attach them to each other. And oh, that frustrated me. Oh my God. I really wanted to keep that terrain manipulation in because I just think it looked so much better with the slope. I removed the whole terrain though just to try it out, and just I wasn't happy with it. So I raised the terrain up again, and then I started thinking about a different method, and I just could not figure it out. But at the end, I did the following thing, and I always have a little bit of trouble with explaining things in the best way, so I hope I'm a little bit clear. And if you still have some questions about it, of course you can ask me in the comments and I will answer them for you. But the thing that I've done was actually over here, which you could just saw on the ground with the two parts. It was before my whole fiddling around started. But I actually removed the left basement, and then I just put a basement attached to the right basement, and I placed it precisely underneath the left building. But I wanted to have it on the front left building where the wooden floor is now. So I placed it precisely underneath there. And then I made it really, really small that I could precisely fit a stair in. And then I removed the ceiling. Then I still had a little bit of a strange slope, but it was between the walls, so it didn't stood out that much. And I covered it up later with a lot of greens. And in that way, I could attach the two parts together. But man, it was annoying. But I'm so happy that I found a solution in the end. Really, I was so happy with that. A thing that I wasn't that happy with was the colors that I went with on this time in the build. I actually really wanted to go with just white on the exterior of the above ground structure. But yeah, I wanted to do something with the ceilings, with the roofs. I didn't want to put roofs in this build. Normally, when I'm building modern builds and I'm creating flat roofs, I really love using the half walls. But yeah, I thought it looked a little bit chunky in this build. I really wanted to keep it very sleek, so I thought, let's just put a roof trim in, or just a trim in, and then paint the ceiling white. But yeah, this is actually the most white ceiling color that we have in the game, and it's still a little bit gray. We have a very bright white one, but it's from Spa Day and it's illuminated, so it's so bright that it glows up during the night. And I just not think that was a very, very pretty. So yeah, as you can see later in this video, I will change up a lot on the roofs, and I wanted to keep it a little bit simple, but then I went with a lot of plants, and I really love using plants in my builds. So yeah, I actually made it a little bit overgrown, but I think it looks very, very pretty. And the same for the plants that I've put in already on the lot. I really love blending the environment of my lots in the lot. The environment of my builds in the lot. So that's exactly what I've done here. And especially because there were a lot of these amazing island living bushes just surrounding the lot. And when you size up these bushes, you can actually really attach them with the plants that are outside your lot. And in that way, yeah, I think especially when you're going to live mode and you cannot see the white line that's surrounding this entire lot, it really looks like it's blended in nature. So I thought that was a fun to do, and it's actually, yeah, kind of easy way, because I could just look to the plants surrounding this lot, and in that way, yeah, the game already made the choices for me according to plants, because normally I can think about which plants to use in my build for a very long time. So yeah, I was very happy with the methods. And as you can see, I've done something different with some of the roofs already. And when I decided to put some plants on this roof, or plants on this roof, yeah, then I just went all the way with all the plants. And I just thought it looked cool, it looked overgrown. I use a lot of these hanging plants, and actually later on I will put a lot of them just on the edge of the hole that you can see already on the ground thing in. So it looks more natural, because of course in real life it's a little bit strange to have a very big hole in the ground, especially on the beach. I was thinking about that because you have a lot of loose sand on the beach, and I think it's structural very, very difficult to create a big hole in the ground on the beach. So that's why I use the terrain paint a lot, and I use a lot of plants just surrounding the hole. Yeah, the whole gap, and I thought it looked a little bit more realistic and a little bit more natural. I really love these items. They're called short slate tiles. Yeah, they're just called slate tiles, but they're in a short and a medium and in a tall version. And yeah, I really love using them in my modern builds. But I think you're almost ready with the whole exterior of this above ground building that's going on. As you can see, for an underground house in this video, there's a lot of building going on above ground. I think half this video is about the building above ground. But I promise you, there will be a lot of things going on underground too. And I especially really love the area where you can lounge, that you can see a little bit of right now, but it's still blank, of course, now. But where you can lounge on the edge of the pool, I think it looks great. But you can see that in a couple of minutes. Of course, I wanted to put some stones on the roofs too. I used these debug items, and I actually used only just one debug item more in this build. That was actually a very big rock that you can see in the environment surrounding this lot too. It's a very big black rock. I sized it a little bit down, and yeah, I put it in the bushes, and I thought it looked a little bit natural. Of course, I wanted to place a mailbox in. I forget to place a mailbox in so many times, and then when I'm taking my screenshots, because when you're moving a sim in and there's not a mailbox, the game just plunks a mailbox in the middle of your living room sometimes, or just in annoying places, and I've had that so many times that I totally forgot a mailbox, and then I took all my screenshots already, and I already made the cinematic intro, and then at the end, after editing the entire video, my eye finally caught the mailbox that was just there in plain sight all the time, and I had to take all my screenshots again. So I already put a mailbox in, and now we're on the interior of the build above ground. Over here there will be the bar. Yeah, I wanted to make it very modern, and I think especially with the very big windows, I think it's such an amazing place to sit over there, that bar, and just a nip from your drink. As you can see, this window is blue on the inside. That's actually the outside of the window. We got some amazing, very big, medium-sized windows from... Medium-sized sounds a little bit strange. They're very big, but according to wall heights, they're the medium wall heights. They are, I think, from the City Living Pack. And I talked about them in a previous video of mine, because I have a hate-love relationship with them. They are so cool because they're so wide, you know, and they just fill up the entire wall. And yeah, I think they're so cool, but the glass is blue. I don't know why the creators made that decision with that window. I think I'm complaining a little bit in this video. I'm so sorry for that. I'm always very, very positive and bubbly, but today I'm complaining a little bit about some things. But yeah, that window, it's blue. But in this build, I actually found out when you flip the window around, the other side of the window isn't blue. How strange is that? In real life, can you imagine that you have a blue window on one side, but on the other side it's just see-through? So strange. But yeah, I was very happy that I found it out because I actually flipped the window around, as you can see. Then you just have the blue glow on the interior, and especially when it's just a bar. No, it's not just a bar, but you have the fuse there. I think it isn't that annoying. Now you where you have a very big blue window and on the exterior of your build, and especially with all my screenshots and everything, I always see that blue window just sticking out. But yeah, I flipped it around and now we have just the normal see-through color on the outside, as you can see, and I think it's so gorgeous now. I just wish they were all in that way, because they're such cool windows. They have a lot of different patterns on it, like with cubes, and yeah, I love it, but I hate it too. And I just placed some lounge chairs in. Of course, you want to have some lounge chairs in a tropical build like this. I think that's an amazing space to lounge. I put two against each other. It's not a mistake. I did that on purpose. I think it looks a little bit like a big bed where you can lounge on with two Sims. I don't know if it really works in the game. I play tested this build, but I totally forgot to play test that little corner of the build. I'm so sorry. I'm not sure if it's working correctly. If it isn't working correctly, I will fix it up before uploading this on the gallery. Of course, I will upload this on the gallery. You can download it. You can put it in your game if you want. But here's some complaining again. I'm so sorry for my complaining today. But I've built this whole thing, then I thought, yeah, let's just save this to the gallery. But because I flipped up the lots, I placed the front of the build actually at the back of this lot. Normally, when I saved the build, it just took the picture of the back of the build. And when I wanted to flip this whole build around just to save it to the library, I couldn't flip it around. I don't know what was happening there. And there was something like conflicting terrain consistency or something, so I couldn't flip it around. So when you find this on the gallery, it looks a little bit strange because, yeah, you can only see the back of the build. So I think, yeah, it's a little bit strange. The lights that I use in this build, the very big ones, they're new, or not new anymore, just a couple of weeks. They are from the Moschino pack. And yeah, I doubt it a little bit to put them in because they're so in your face, they're so out there. But I think they're very modern and I think they're very fine made, so I just put them in. Normally they're a little bit smaller, but I size them up because this is actually two stories high. I thought it just looked cooler to do it in that way. Over here I'm creating an area to barbecue. I use this area, not this area, I use this barbecue from the perfect patio, I think, yeah. The perfect patio pack. I think it's gorgeous. I use it in all of my modern Sulani builds, especially the pink color. And I had the barbecue in mind, and that pink color actually determines my color choices throughout this entire build. So lounge chairs are pink too. That's only because I have the pink color of the barbecue in mind. I think it's just gorgeous, and especially in a tropical world like this. And yeah, now we're onto the underground house, and we're already 20 minutes in. And yeah, so only the last 10 minutes of this underground house or underground build is underground. But of course, with a lot of plants and a lot of things going on above ground, it took me more time to build the above ground structure than to decorate the underground. But yeah, I wanted to keep it modern, but I wanted to keep it a little bit fun too. So I used some of the new Moschino pack items. I wanted to use some softer pinks, as I was mentioning, the color of the barbecue. I also put these colors in the interior in the underground house, but I also wanted to combine that with some softer reds and some softer yellows. So I wanted to keep it in that color scheme. As you can see, I put a lot of plants over here too as well. Of course, when you're underground, you cannot see how it blends together with above ground. But I think especially when you are above ground, you could just saw for a couple of seconds. I think it looks way more natural with all the plants. And I actually think it looks better underground too. You still have a little bit of a touch with nature, you know, when you are underground. I really wanted to keep the underground like that and a little bit bright, because I didn't want to make it look like it was a dungeon, you know, like dark on the ground. That's why I made a choice for the white wooden floor. And yeah, as you can see, I already painted the walls over here. It saved me a little bit time for this whole video, so I already painted the walls. And yeah, as you can see, a lot of white. I think in that way it was a little bit more brighter. So that's why I made a choice. The area that was working on just a couple of minutes ago, I'm onto the kitchen right now, and I'm really loving this kitchen too. I think it looks very cool with darker wood and with white, and I think it just blends well together. I used the concrete on the walls. The concrete is actually from the Jungle Adventure Pack, and when I'm doing industrial builds, I always use this concrete. I think it looks just cool with the structure and the texture on it. And I almost forgot the refrigerator. I almost forgot it. And oh yeah, I was talking about the previous space with the whole pool. Actually, I really like that space. I think it's so cool. I really just want to lay there. You just lounge there. I don't know if that was the correct sentence, but I really just want to lounge there. And especially because you have the hole in the ground, and you can, when you're chilling over there, you can see the sky, and but you're still on the ground. Yeah, I think that was cool to do. This couch, this is a couch from the Moschino pack, and yeah, it's a little bit out there, but I thought, yeah, with all the softer pinks and the whites that I've used in this build and the yellows, yeah, just one like a statement piece. I thought it was cool. I combined the couch with the lounge chair, and in that way, and the side table, and in that way I could create this L-shaped sofa. And yeah, I think it just looks cool, so that's why I went with it. Over here is the first bedroom. As you can see, I already put a pink wall in, and I thought it was fun to, yeah, just incorporate the color. And I also use a lot of the island living items. But as you can see, I really wanted to keep this part very bright. And yeah, I'm actually very happy with the end result. And on your right will be a very big bathroom. There is another very small bathroom with a toilet in that I already decorated over here too. And there's a bathroom upstairs too. There's only a bath though. So yeah, and I actually forgot to place a toilet in the very big bathroom. So if you think, oh, she totally forgot it, when I play tested this build, I actually put a toilet in over there. So yeah, everything is okay. Here we're on to the second bedroom. Yeah, I kept it a little bit in the same vibe with a lot of very soft, warmer colors. And yeah, I really wanted to create, yeah, a soft vibe, so I thought, yeah, that was pretty to do. But I think I almost said enough for now, and I think we're almost at the end of this video too. Only a couple of minutes to go. Of course, there will be some screenshots at the end of this video. I really hope you like this build. There will be some modern builds coming this week, for the reason that I explained at the beginning of this video, because there's a lot of fantasy builds coming later on. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do. I would really, really appreciate it. I hope you will have a great day today. And I hope to talk to you soon, maybe in one of my next videos. Or maybe you want to watch one of my previous videos. And well, goodbye!